cordially welcome the Chief Guest, the Honorable Chief Justice Mr. K. Sribhavan, Professor PMS Gunaratna, Vice Chairman University Grants Commission, Senior Professor Ms. Vasanti Arasaratnam, Special Guest Honorable Mr. M. Ilanchalian, High Court Judge Jaffna, Mr. Honorable Mrs. K. Sivapada Sundaram, Commissioner of the High Court Civil Appellate Division Jaffna, Mr. Madhava Thennakoon, Senior State Counsel, the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran, Professor Subhathini Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law, and everyone present here for gracing the occasion of the Aluminum Jubilee Celebration of the Department of Law, University of Jaffna. K. Sribhavan, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, to light the first lamp. M. Dakshani, Dilhara Kunatilaka, Sajani Nisansa, Krishani Bhagya, Ishani Vasana, Irosha Sandamali, and Sahani Vijaypur.
established. But the first batch of law students were admitted in the year 2005, and now we all are proud together to celebrate our 10th year of existence and Law Chief Neelam, the annual journal of the law students. Our chief guest is Law Chief, Chief Justice of Sri Lanka, Sir, and law student of Jaffna Hindu College, and later the Law College. You had an excellent career at Attorney General's Department before admitted into the bench. With your wide legal knowledge, experience and integrity, you have rise to the topmost position of the judiciary of this country. We all are very, very fortunate to have you here within your tight schedule. On behalf of the University of Jaffna and Department of Law, I warmly welcome you, sir. One of our guest of honor today is the Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission, Professor P.M. Sudharatne. Sir, after graduating from the University of Sri Jayawardenepura with excellence, you completed your master's and doctorate in Japan. Being a professor at the University of Colombo, the Honorable President has very correctly appointed you as the Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission. On behalf of our university community, I am privileged to welcome you, sir. We all are very much honored and happy due to the presence of our Vice Chancellor, Senior Professor Vasanthi Arasaratnam, today with us. Being a graduate from our own university, she was Head Biochemistry, Dean Faculty of Medicine, and now our Vice Chancellor. Madam, every one of us can witness the developments taking place at Tirunelveli, Trinochi, and Vaunia in the academic side, as well as the infrastructure developments. She is always flexible to adjust many things for the betterment of the student community. Our next guest is Honorable Justice M. Ranjani, sir, High Court Judge Jaffna. Sir, an old student of Senior College, Jaffna, you completed your Bachelor of Law degree at University of Colombo, completed Master's degree in Sri Lanka and Hong Kong, and admitted to the bench. After holding several posts in the judicial service with extreme credit, you were honored by even foreign organizations for your credible and far-reaching service. Welcoming you to this function, the law students, Department of Law, and the university community are very happy you have raised these 10th year celebrations. Our esteemed guest, Honorable Kanaka Subhavan Sundaram Madam, an old student of Weather Sports Coimbatore, and later the Law College of Sri Lanka, who commenced your career as an attorney at law and later admitted to the bench. At present, you are holding the post of Commissioner of High Court Jaffna. We all are happy in welcome you, Madam. Our esteemed guest, Mr. Madhav Tenakon, sir, currently a senior state counsel, administration for Attorney General's Department. You studied in the Law College of Sri Lanka and completed your master's program in Italy. Joining the Attorney General's Department in 1997, you are in the 19th year of your committed service in the department. Finding time within your tight schedule, you have come from Colombo to grace this function. We are very happy to welcome you, sir. We, the entire law students, are indebted to our Dean, Faculty of Arts, Professor Enyanakumaran, and our Head, Department of Law, Professor Subhadri Ramesh, for their commitment and devotion towards the law students of this university. Without their untiring efforts and commitment, we may not be in a position to complete our academic program in time. I am very much pleased to welcome our Dean and Head of the Department of Law for this memorable occasion. I am sure that our Dean and Head of the Department will also be proud to hold these positions during this 10th year anniversary. Finally, I wish to welcome all our invitees, Honorable Judges, Lawyers, Deans, Academic and Administrative Staff of the University, fellow students and well-wishers who are present here. Kindly cooperate with the organizers and pardon any mistake or omissions in my welcome speech as well as the student programs that we follow, and hope you all will enjoy your presence with us today. Thank you.
Guest of Honor, Professor P.M.S. Sunaratna, Vice Chairman, University Grants Commission. Senior Professor Ms. Vasanti Arasaratnam, Vice Chancellor, University of Jaffna. Honorable Mr. M. Ilanchalian, Judge at the High Court of Jaffna. Honorable Mrs. Kanaka Sivapati Sundaram, Commissioner of the High Court Civil Appellate Division, Jaffna. Mr. Madhava Janakun, Senior State Counsel, Attorney General's Department, Colombo. Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran, Dean of the Faculty of Arts. And Professor Subhasini Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law. Professor Mrs. Ramesh was appointed as Head of the Department of Law in 2012, and we truly thank and appreciate the effort on her part to take this department to higher levels.
Since the department was inaugurated in 2005, which particularly fits to Mr. N. Selvakumaran, Senior Lecturer and former Dean of the Faculty of Law, Colombo, the advisory committee members and all our well-wishers. We are very thankful for your eternal assistance and we look forward to receive your counsel, advice and guidance in marking the progress of our department in coming years. We extend our special thanks to the marrow of the formation and the growth of this department, Ms. Shanta Abhimansingham, the Vice Chancellors, Professor Balasundaram Pillai, Professor Mohanadas, Professor Ishan Malinger, and Acting Vice Chancellor Professor Kumar Varigay, who have done everything in their capacity to support the growth of our department. We are also grateful to our former Deans of the Faculty of Arts and the heads of the departments who were the voice of our department and enormously sacrificed themselves in providing the quality of education. We cannot fulfill the advice of this history without expressing our gratitude to our current Vice Chancellor, Madam Vasanti Arasaratnam. Your connection to our department is special and always we remember who carry out this history marking journey. We want to acknowledge the service rendered by the staff from Colombo who have been taking care of our final year students throughout this period, and I share my sincere thanks to Mr. V. N. Tambu, who has been the bridge of our department to successfully conduct our academic programs in Colombo. I feel extremely pleased and proud to place this exclusive issue of the Aluminium Jubilee Souvenir in the hands of our esteemed stakeholders, former students, former staff members, present students, present staff members, and the community at large who have been associated with the department in the past as well as today. This special issue has been compiled and produced in active cooperation with the organizing committee of the society in marking 10 years of its glorious existence. I hope this landmark document will prove as the witness of to our enlightening and intellectual journey so far. While congratulating the editorial board of this souvenir for their commendable job, I wish to express my continuous support and encouragement to the Law Society for such future endeavors. This wishes to Neelam, the annual magazine of the Department of Law, which is also going to be launched today. It was such unfortunate that we could not be able to launch Needham last year. However, with support of all, we are happy to launching this embracing journal today, and I am sure it will be an intellectual treat to all of you. Read. On behalf of the department, I take this moment to sincerely thank the renowned speakers for today and all who have given messages to the Swarnia and Needham. We also pay our gratitude to our sponsors, associates, and members of the organizing and program committee. I want to conclude my remarks by thanking once again all of you for coming here on Sunday morning. And I also want to note that along with the support of UGC, the university administration, and all, We are hopeful to conduct all year classes at University of Jaffna itself. Further, even though in the beginning the law was decided to be formed as in the capacity of the faculty, due to the unavoidable circumstances and lack of resources, being the department was not able to be promoted. However, on marking this occasion, we are confident that we will work together with everyone tirelessly, the university administration, the UGC, and all of the stakeholders in marking the next Jublee in the stand of faculty with adequate resources and facilities. It's a time of joy and jubilation, a time to recall the innumerable blessings of God and thank Him from our bottom of hearts for all that the department has been able to achieve in the past 10 years. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for those descriptive and encouraging words to everyone. Now I would like to call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Senior Professor N. Nanakumaran, to make his address. Would also like to take this time to thank you, sir, for supporting the department in your various capacities as Dean and as Head of the Department of Law to ensure adequate resources and facilities to the department during your tenure.
Your Lordship, Justice Sri Bhavan, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, and the distinguished Chief Guest at this function, Professor P.S.N. Gunaratna, Vice Chairman of the University Grant Commission, who is our guest of honor today, Senior Professor Vasanthi Arasaratnam, Vice Chancellor of our university, Honorable Palanchalian, Judge of the Jaffna Provincial High Court, Honorable Mrs. K. Sobhadasundaram, Commissioner of the High Court, Jaffna, Mr. Madhavati Nakun, Senior State Counselor, Attorney General's Department, Colombo, Mr. S. Paramaraja, Retired High Court Commissioner, former Vice Chancellors of the University, Professor Kumaravadivir, Professor Mohan Das, and Professor Subedini Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law, University of Jaffna, other distinguished judges, guests, and invitees, distinguished deans, Faculty of Science and Faculty of Engineering, professors, heads of departments, staff of the university, former students, ever active present students, and members of the student union associations, ladies and gentlemen. I am glad to stand before you to say a few words at the occasion when the Department of Law and the University of Jaffna mark and celebrate the 10th anniversary of the establishment of the Department of Law in the university. The passage of 10 years is an important milestone in the history of the department, though some may feel that it is not the case when the institution is compared with much older bodies than just the 10. Be that as it may, it is a momentous event in the history of Department of Law for a variety of reasons, some of which I would wish to highlight here. When we look back at the initial move to establish the Department of Law, we remember with gratitude the groundswell of support that was shown by the authorities both in the university system and beyond. This includes the University Grant Commission, the judiciary of, in particular, the then Chief Justice, the Council of Legal Education, and a well-established law teaching institution, in particular, the Faculty of Law of the University of Colombo, and the Honorable Attorney Generals and the unofficial bar. It was with the ever-willing support and best wishes of all concerned that we did commence the Department of Law in the university in June 2005. Our beginning was very modest and we started with 2 full-time law teachers. But we had the service of some experienced teachers and practitioners as visiting lecturers. However, this was short-lived due to the civil unrest which recommenced within a short span of its existence. The department did not have any control over those events, and the department experienced severe hardship due to these developments, which resulted in then low teachers leaving the service. The low students of those days suffered as a result, and naturally they did nurse some grudge against the institution. The department made alternative arrangements to cope up with the situation, and we managed to tide over the unexpected turn of events. This made us to send batches of students, third year and fourth year students, to Kalambu to be taught by visiting lecturers in the Kalambu Center, which practice is still continuing but restricted to the final year only in the last few years. So the road that we travel on has been bumpy, not as smooth as we started the journey. Our main problem is the difficulty in recruiting and retaining qualified staff in the department. This academic discipline provides a pathway to a lucrative profession, and naturally, therefore, it is not easy to retain those who are recruited in the university system unless they are reasonably compensated. We are, however, in the process of getting over this difficulty, but with some struggle. We hope in a couple of years we should be fairly stable with regard to our staff requirements. Amidst all these difficulties, we have achieved considerable success in the short period of 10 years. The students have performed well, not only in their curricular activities, but also in many extracurricular activities, which have transcended the university's boundaries. They have actively participated in many extension programs towards discharging their duties by the society at large. They have brought credit to the institution by these performances. It is due to the commitment and dedication of the staff and students which made these possible. It is with some degree of satisfaction and happiness I recollect the fact that I was the first head of the Department of Law when it was established in the University of Jaffna, and now I am before you as the Dean of the Faculty of Arts when it celebrates its 10th birthday. I take this opportunity to wish the department, its staff and the students all the best, very, very best wishes and success in all their endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for those retrospective words which evoke fond memories in the hearts of many of us here. Now, I would like to call upon the Vice Chancellor of the University of Jaffna, Senior Professor Ms. Vasanthi Arasaratnam, to present her address. We would also like to thank you, ma'am, for your supervision and for the guidance given to the department over the years.
Our chief guest, the Lordship Honorable K. Sribhavan, guest of honor, and the Vice Chairman, University Grants Commission, Professor Gunaratnan, special guest, Honorable Mr. Ilanjaniyan, Mrs. K. Sivababa Sundaram, and Mr. Manava Tenakon, the Dean, Faculty of Arts, the Head Department of Law, the former Vice Chancellors, Professor Mohanadas and Professor Kumar Vadivel, the Deans of the Faculties, the members from the Judiciary Department, my academic colleagues, and my dear students and the invitees. I am very happy to be here and proud that we were able to complete 10 years of this establishment of the Law Department. As the student said, even though the dream of this university was to start this law faculty during its inception, the university was able to start this Department of Law during the period of Professor Mohanadas, who was the then Vice Chancellor. And all the hardships which has been faced by this department were really resolved by the former Vice Chancellor, Professor Kumar Vadivel, when the department started to grow. So therefore, at this juncture, I am happy that the law department students have honored to invite them And also they are gracing this occasion at this moment. Thank you very much for Professor Mohanadas and Professor Kumaravadivel for gracing this occasion, because you are the key people to establish and to really resolve the problems mainly of this law department. And I am very happy that the law students have been trying to invite the Chief Justice from the inception of this Department of Law, and they have been trying their level best during the launching of this NIDA magazine. Only today, for this aluminium celebration, we were able to get our Lordship Honorable Sri Bhavan here. So we are very thankful you to sir for gracing this occasion on behalf of the University of Jaffna. And our Vice Chairman, I think, who is really behind us and helping us a lot, both in the infrastructure development mainly, I think, and also the other activities of our university. Again, I would like to thank the University Grants Commission, the Chairman, as well as the Vice Chairman on behalf of the university. And thank you very much, Honorable Lanchelian. We know your capacity and your aspirations and your love towards our society. We want your service to Jaffna. So we hope you will be with us and will be serving this community. Honorable Mrs. Swabhavasundaram, thank you very much for coming and gracing this occasion. And I am proud that we are having a lady here as a Commissioner of High Courts. Again, I would like to thank Mr. Madhav Tenakovan, because we know we have a lot of support from your department, and your support is always needed for our university. Thank you very much for gracing this occasion. And I think the head of the department, as well as the dean of the faculty, they have been talking about the history of this department. As a person who is also from a faculty where we have the professional students, I always say that the law department, the law course is also a professional course, and the students also should behave like professionals. So I think in between sometimes I would have been very strict with you all, because you people should know what is law and how to behave according to the law. So there only I had some problems in controlling your activities. So being the law students, I believe you have to behave, and you also have to remember you are also the students of this university, and you are also the students of the Faculty of Arts. Anyway, I know your hardships. We are also trying to do our level best to have a quality education for us. And also I would like to say here something incomparable with what I had and experienced with the medical faculty during my deanship. When I was in the dean, as the dean medicine, I have been running the faculty with only 12 staff, whereas we should have had 70 staff. So we have been inviting visiting lecturers, we have been sending students to Medical, Trincomalee, Vaudia. So here also, since we want you to have a quality education, we are still sending you to Colombo. But once our own academics get their qualification and experience, you will definitely have your full education here in Jaffna. I believe the professional courses can't have any compromise with the quality. Therefore, we will have to continue with this final year training for you all for some more years until we get quality staff to our department. However, I believe you have to bear with us for this problem, and we will try to resolve these problems as much as possible. And also when I took over, we have been trying to have lectures from Colombo through video conferencing, and which also we could not succeed. But now Professor Mr. Selvakumaran was here for some time. His support also cannot be forgotten. And I believe in future we will get more and more support from other law department staff from the Columbia University, and we will definitely try to have a better quality education for you. But however, at this moment, I also would like to thank the former heads of the departments of law and the former deans of the Faculty of Arts for cooperating with me to maintain the quality of education. And I believe at the moment, the present head has really taken a lot of effort to clear all the backlogs which have been there in the law department. Personally, I would like to congratulate her for her effort and the time she has devoted to do this. Anyway, thank you very much for the law students. And again, I wish you all the best and congratulate you all for celebrating this ceremony and launching this Needham magazine. And again, I would like to thank our chief guest and the guest of honors, special guest, for gracing this occasion. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for those words of gratitude on behalf of the University of Jaffna extended to our distinguished panel of guests. We also would like to thank you for those edifying words to the students. We would now like to invite Professor Kumara Vadivel, former Vice Chancellor of the University of Jaffna, to this event. Thank you, sir, for gracing this event. We would also like to invite Professor Siva Chandran, former Dean of the Faculty of Arts, for attending this event. Thank you, sir. We would now like to launch this souvenir, which marks 10 years of the Department of Law. The souvenir attempts to encapsulate the journey of the department and to revisit those events that have contributed towards its prestige and excellence. The souvenir briefly provides the history of the department, and it carries messages from the Chief Justice himself, Honorable K. Sribhavan, and Senior Professor Ms. Vasanthi Arasaratnam, Vice Chancellor, Honorable Mr. M. Ilanchalian, Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivapada Sundaram, Ms. Shanta Abhimanasingham, the Dean, Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran, the Head of the Department of Law, Professor Mrs. Subhathini Ramesh, Mr. B. N. Thambu, Mr. N. Selvakumaran, Mr. V. T. Tamilmaran, Mr. A. Sarveswaran, and messages from the lecturers Mrs. Khosle Madan, Mr. Kumaravadivel Gurupuran, Mrs. Tushani Shayantan, Mrs. Puradhani Madanaranjan, and messages from the presidents and secretaries of the Law Alumni Association and the Law Student Society. We would like to call upon the Vice Chancellor to launch the souvenir. Madam, we would like to call upon you to launch the souvenir by presenting the first copy to the chief guest, His Lordship Honorable K. Sribhavan. Ma'am, if you would also be obliged to present the next copy to the Vice Chairman of the UGC, Professor P.M.S. Gunaratnam. If I could humbly call upon the Chief Guest to present a copy of the souvenir to the Vice Chancellor. Thank you, sir. We would also now request the Vice Chancellor once again to present a copy of the souvenir to Mr. M. Ilanchalian. We also invite Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivapada Sundaran to receive the next copy of the souvenir from the hand of the Vice Chancellor. Now I would like to invite Mr. Madhavatenakum to receive a copy of the souvenir. We now invite Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran, Dean of the Faculty of Arts, to receive a copy of the souvenir. We call upon the Head of the Department of Law, Professor Subhathini Ramesh, to receive a copy of the souvenir. Thank you, ma'am, for presenting the souvenir. We would now have a slideshow, and we would like to call upon the chief guest, His Lordship, to initiate the slide presentation, which visualizes the contents contained in the souvenir.
Good morning, everyone. Today, we mark the Aluminum Jubilee of Department of Law. First of all, thank you, Your Lordship, for launching this presentation. It is a small slideshow, but your launch gives us so encouragement to work for better outcome in coming years. Next. The University of Jaffna, established in 1974, the one only well-known institution which have been contributing to the academia and for producing intellectuals. The first picture is in the slide is the landmark of Jaffna, so does the second building. Next. The Department of Law was formed in 2005 with the support of many. We are so thankful to everyone who had contributed in the inauguration, but also throughout in its growth. Next. The inauguration function was pretty simple. However, all who stood up for it believed that the formation of department would make a huge contribution to the society, so does it for last 10 years. Next. Thanks to our Vice Chancellors, Professor P. Balasundaram Pillai, Professor S. Mohanadas, Professor R. Gumara Badivel, Professor N. Sanmugalingam, for their contribution in growth of our department. Madam Vice Chancellor, we are very grateful to you for your unconditional support and guidance that we mark this history as a successful one. Next. Thanks to our heads of the department, from them, Professor N. Yanakumaran, current Dean of Faculty of Arts, Professor V. P. Sivanathan, Professor M. Sinathambi, Dr. T. Kalamani, who have sacrificed themselves in the promotion of our department. Professor Subhadini Ramesh is our current head of the department, and on behalf of all of the students, we thank you, Madam, for your leadership, courage, and for the will in making our education success. Next, thank you to our present and past lecturers, who are the backbone of success of every of us. Next. Thanks to our coordinator, Mr. B. N. Tambu, the threat of our department representing at Colombo, and have been the mentor of final year students. Next, we are thankful particularly to Mr. N. Selvakumaran, Mr. V. T. Tamilmaran, Dr. S. Sagaraja Sagaram, and Mr. A. Sarveswaran, who never hesitate but put their time in making us good citizens of this country. Next. We mark this history with many milestones, which particularly fits with the graduation. This is the first batch. Next. Second and third batch on the screen. Next. Fourth batch on the screen. Next. Fifth batch on the screen. Next. Sixth batch on the screen. Next. Seventh batch on the screen. Next. 8th batch on the screen. Next. 9th batch on the screen. Next. 10th batch on the screen. Next. Being a student is also involved in taking part in the public publication of our annual magazine, Needham. So far, 4 magazines have been launched, and we are very proud that the 5th one will be launched today at this function. Next. Students' achievements always matter. Here the couple of pictures, you see the day of convocations of our seniors. See how they are happy and proud. Next. Few of our past students who have completed their postgraduate education, Ms. T. Sayandan, Mr. S. Nissan, Ms. D. Douglas, Ms. D. Sudhakar, had completed their masters, where Mr. T. Vinodan and Mr. S. Pradinath have been reading. Next. Students become as the lecturer at the same institution is always a proud moment. And that happened to 4 of our lecturers, Ms. T. Sayandan, Ms. D. Sudhakar, Ms. P. Madanarajan, and Mr. S. Pradinath are those lecturers, and we are proud we have them at our department. Next. Students involved in many events at and outside university, and here are few for your views. Next. Our students participated in number of national level competitions, seminars, publication ceremonies, etc. Next. Our students also participated in seminars on legal topics and in conferences in issues such as land law and green laws. Next. Leadership conferences, human rights courses, short film productions are some more. Our students participated. Next. Our students also participated in the international conferences in Japan, Philippines, Korea, India, and in many countries. Today's host, Sloma David, who won the Best Mooter Award at the South Asian IHL Moot Court competition, is one of the most examples for our victories. Next. Our students also shine in the sports, and few pictures for your views who got colors at various sports. Next. We conduct many events, and the pictures you see is the celebration of Saraswati Puja at Jaffna as well as in Colombo. You can see how our students are being as devotees. Next. We also once celebrate Sinhala Tamil New Year, and it was fun. You can see the pictures taken at the moment, and the group picture of all of us being as one family. Next. In promoting sports at the department level, LUDAS was formed in 2014, and we conducted many sports events. Few pictures for your views. Next. We also mark the first day of the inauguration of our department as the Department Day, and we cut cake and shares. It reminds us what our head of the department mentioned. The day to come to see our department grow as the faculty of law. Next. Thank you for all viewing this presentation, and may God be with all of us and with the department in making more and more progress. Thank you.
It is our privilege and pleasure that the Honorable Chief Justice Mr. K. Srivavan has accepted our invitation a second time to attend a function conducted by the University of Jaffna. The Chief Justice was the chief guest at the launch of the first volume of the Needham Law Journal, and we are honored that he has graced this occasion of the Aluminum Jubilee celebration with his presence. If I may bring to your memory an excerpt from his honor's acceptance speech delivered at his appointment as Chief Justice, which is fitting to be voiced at this event, it reads, and I quote, "The strength of the judiciary entirely consists in the moral allegiance which it can evoke by the hold it has over the hearts of the people, and in this respect it may be borne in mind that a good bench means a good and efficient bar. Both lawyers and judges ought to be conscious of the radical changes that are taking place in the fundamental aspects of the law. The future holds a challenge for all members of our profession, for the law must be stable, it cannot be static. Changing times throw down new challenges, and changing situations pose new problems. Since we are standing at the threshold of a momentous era in the history of our country, the work we are doing at present and will do in the future should amount to a substantial contribution in shaping the future of our country." We would now like to call upon the chief guest, His Lordship, to address the audience.
Senior Professor Mrs. Arasaratnam, Vice Chancellor of the University of Jaffna, Professor Gunaratna, Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission, Honorable Ilanchalian High Court Judge Jaffna, Honorable Sivapatha Sundaram, Commissioner of High Court Jaffna, Mr. Madhava Tennakon, Senior State Counsel, Attorney General's Department, Professor Jnana Kumaran, Professor Mrs. Ramesh, Professor Mohanadas, Professor Kumaravadivel, Honorable Judges, Sitting Judges and the retired judges who are present here today, my dear students, ladies and gentlemen. It's a matter of great joy for me to stand here today as the chief guest at the Aluminum Jubilee celebration of the Department of Law of the University of Jaffna. I am happy that Mr. Selvakumaran persuaded me to accept the invitation to attend today's celebration in spite of my reluctance to do so due to an extremely hectic and demanding work schedule. In fact, Friday evening when I left Colombo, I had to take 15 files with me. I told my driver to put back the files in the vehicle. He was asking me, "Sir, you are going to Jaffna, why are you taking the files?" So I had to tell him that I had to sit on Tuesday, there are some cases coming up, I had to study those briefs. In fact, Mr. Madhava Tennakon was there on Friday before me, appearing in a case. Soon after that, both of us left. Maybe I don't know whether he left on Friday or on Saturday, but I had to leave Friday evening itself. I am indeed happy to be associated with the Aluminum celebrations of the Department of the Law of University of Jaffna, and also wish to congratulate all those who have associated with this faculty during the last decade and continue to do so today on its success. As I pondered on what I should talk about today, my mind flashed back to things that have been of value in my life, and I thought I should use this opportunity to share some of my views with all of you present here today, with the hope that you may learn from some of my experiences. I consider life to be a series of opportunities And whatever opportunity we have, if we try to do our best in a spirit of dedication, we will have the blessings of the divine. Greatness is a combination of ability and opportunity. You may have the ability. If you do not get the opportunity, nothing happens. If you have the opportunity but do not have the ability, nothing happens. It's a combination of ability and opportunity that gives you a modest amount of success in life. The two ingredients for success or greatness are human effort and the grace of God. Whatever work we undertake, small or great, if we throw ourselves into it, and if we discharge our functions in a spirit of dedication, it does not matter whether by the worldly standards we succeed or fail. We would have done our duty. Each and everyone in the university, or for that matter in any university, should have a sense of pride, a sense of craftsmanship aiming at excellence, whatever be the work that is allotted to him or her. Whatever work you undertake, it must be your endeavor to throw yourself heart and soul into it and try to achieve some high standards of excellence. What follows does not matter. You should always remember that discipline should be our way of life. I recall reading this verse long time back, which goes as, I quote, "Make yourself strong, so strong that when God writes your fate, he asks you, 'Tell me, what do you want?'" Unquote. The message in this verse is that we control our own lives and therefore our own fates. Depend on no one, do what is right, be determined and focused, and choose your own goals. Even if the whole world is against you, do what you believe is right and live by the principles. It sounds so easy to live by the principles, but I know it is not easy to adhere to the principles and your values, no matter how difficult the circumstances can be. Look at people who have no discipline. They are miserable. This is the stage when you should learn the value of discipline. Freedom without discipline is absolute misery. Discipline without freedom is suffocating. Discipline is not something just for students. It's a life skill that is essential to your success in love, life, and happiness. It is essential to our society. Without this disciplined enthusiasm for great causes, students become a danger to themselves and to the society as a whole. Youth is the stage in life when the slightest turn towards wrong will spell disaster. Discipline is therefore necessary for all achievements, especially great achievements. Discipline is following rules and customs even though no one else is there to see us do it, because we respect the origin or fear the consequences of these rules, we generally accept them as the right way to do things. It gives us our integrity and honor, which is a crucial part of who we are. You can be disciplined only when the teachers, the parents, the leaders of the society are all disciplined. The entire nation must learn to control the wild nature of passions and emotions. Make yourselves fit for this by making the best use of opportunities when you are in a higher educational institution. However high you move up on the ladder of education, do not let the roots of our culture dry up in your heart. You should always remember that students are the real promoters of the prosperity of the future of any country. They must therefore cultivate strong virtues and be courageous and enthusiastic helpers of society. Students should not become cowards. As students, you should try to develop an optimistic attitude towards life. Thoughts automatically give rise to actions. Actions in turn produce habits, and habits then form man's character. It is the character which decides our destiny for good or bad. Character is that one on which the destiny of a nation is built. Whether in public life or in student life, we cannot reach great heights if we are lacking in character. If I can be proud of anything, it is that as a student, I tried to do my best and I aimed at doing my best. When I was a student, I never thought that one day I will become the Chief Justice of this country. This could not have been anticipated. You just take up life, allow it to grow according to its own principal pattern, and be a willing instrument of the working out, the evolution of that pattern. You must have sufficient humility to feel that nothing depends on yourself. It is not only your endeavor and your effort, but it is the grace of God in whom you have complete confidence. It is that takes you step by step. One cannot go to the top without a struggle. You must have faith in the ultimate victory. You must gather courage and faith from wherever you can get them. Treasure all the confidence and courage you get from your experience and do not let them slip from your grasp. I also believe that education should be imparted with a view to the type of society that we wish to build. If education is to help us to meet the moral challenge of the age and play its part in the life of the community, it should be liberating and life-giving. It must give a basic meaning to the personality and existence and equip us with the power to overcome spiritual inertia. Teachers play an important role in this regard. Teachers have a great deal to do with the shaping of the minds and hearts of our youth. We speak of national integration, of peaceful approach to the problems that face us. But this cannot be realized by mere preaching. We have to be educated to a realization of it. We should not lower the standards of rectitude. Teachers, by their conduct, should be an example to the students. Good conduct is produced only by a wise self-restraint. Nowhere does the superior mind disclose itself better than in self-restraint. Most of you here will be enrolled as attorneys at law within the next 2 or 3 years, or some of you even earlier. As such, you may all be aware that while the legal profession throughout the world is moving in this age of high technology into a totally unprecedented manner of handling its business, the time-honored prerequisites for the proper discharge of the lawyers role remains unimpaired. In this age of electronics and international commerce, they remain as important as they were when the lawyer's business was transacted by handwritten documents. There's a very high standard of integrity which is looked upon as the norm in the profession, to which every lawyer must aspire to conform. It must be one of the basic attitudes of this profession, which every aspiring lawyer acquires in the course of his or her training, and which he or she automatically assumes will be the standard to be complied with. Moreover, compliance does not come through fear of adverse consequences in the event of non-compliance, but because those standards are internally accepted as part and parcel of the expectations of the public and of the profession. Remember, there must also be a sense of dedication to the lawyer's calling. The law is not a trade where pursuit of the rupee is the lawyer's principal goal. The law is a vocation. It demands a spirit of dedication to the ideals for which it stands. Dedication to the rule of law and the protection of individual rights and freedoms is the essence of the lawyer's commitment. All that he or she does not be done within the matrix of this all-embracing framework. Any departure from them takes the lawyer outside the ambit of his profession. As you will agree, the legal profession in the past has been characterized by extreme legalism and still in many countries continue to be overly legalistic. However, the growing emphasis today is that the law is only a means towards an end. That end is justice. One of the tests of the maturity of a legal profession is its ability to see the purposes behind the law and give effect to the spirit of the law rather than the letter. Today, there's a growing demand for justice rather than law. The legal profession, therefore, will need to cater to this demand through its educational processes, its professional ethics, and its revived dedication to justice. There is an observation of Aristotle, which I would like to quote. I quote, "Man, when perfected, is the best of animals, but when separated from law and justice, he is the worst of all, since armed injustice is the more dangerous, and he is equipped at birth with arms meant to be used by intelligence and virtue, which he may use for the worst ends. Therefore, if he has no virtue, he is the most unholy and most savage of the animals," unquote. It is my hope, my dear students, it is my prayer that the University of Jaffna will continue to produce and mold into this world men and women of knowledge and virtue, of skills and refinement, who will bring glory not only to the university but to the country at large. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for that wonderful and enlightening address. I hope that everyone here will remember and cherish those words that were spoken here. Thank you once again. Now we would like to invite the head of the Department of Law, Professor Subhatini Ramesh, to present the memento to our distinguished panel of guests. We call upon the Chief Justice to receive the memento from the hand of the head of the Department of Law. We call upon the Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission, Professor Gunaratna, to receive the memento. We would now kindly request the Vice Chancellor, Senior Professor Vasanthi Arasaratnam, to receive the memento. I would like to kindly invite Honorable Mr. M. Elanchalian, High Court Judge of Jaffna, to receive the memento. I kindly invite Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivapadasundaram, Commissioner of the High Court Civil Appellate Division, to receive the memento. I call upon Mr. Madhava Tenakun, Senior State Counsel, Attorney General's Department, to receive the memento. So I could kindly request Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran to come forward and receive the memento. Now, if I can kindly request the Vice Chancellor to present the memento to Professor Mrs. Subhatini Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law. Thank you, Madam, and thank you, Mrs. Ramesh, for presenting the mementos. I would now like to invite our guest of honor, Professor P.M.S. Gunaratna, Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission, to speak a few words. The University Grants Commission has been instrumental in ensuring a smooth intake of new students and in recruiting lecturers to the university. We, as a student body, are truly thankful for the work done behind the scenes to ensure a quality tertiary education.
Very good day to all of you, Your Lordship, Honorable K.C. Pavan, Chief Justice, Supreme Court of Sri Lanka, Senior Professor Mrs. Vasanthi Arasaratnam, Vice Chancellor, University of Colombo. Special guest, Honorable M. Elchanayam, High Court Judge, Jaffna. Honorable Mrs. K. Sivapatha Sutram, Commissioner of High Court, Jaffna. Mr. Madhava Tennakon, Senior State Counsel, Attorney General Department, Colombo. Former Vice Chancellors, Professor Mohandas, Professor Vadivel, Dean of the Faculty of Arts, to which this Department of Law belongs to, Professor Mr. Jnana Kumaran, Heads of the Law, Heads of the Department of Law, Professor Subhitini Ramesh, Deans of Faculties, Heads of Departments, Professors, Fellow Academics, Dear Students, Ladies and Gentlemen, I am indeed honored and privileged to be here as a representative of University Grants Commission, at the time Department of Law celebrating its 10th year anniversary. In fact, I regard it as a cardinal responsibility or duty of the UGC. I wholeheartedly congratulate the head of department, students and the staff, and also those who associated with developing this wonderful department at the University of Jaffna. I'm not going to deliver a special speech here, but some of my random thoughts let me share with you. Jaffna and its people have been remarkably visible and always and stand tall compared to the rest of the country for many reasons. Jaffna evolved as an educational hub since pre-independence era. So such hubs we could have seen in Colombo, maybe in Gaul, maybe in Kandy. The Jaffna people understood the importance of education, as a result of which it produced a lot of good leaders as well as professionals to this country. Great sons of Jaffna worked closely with southern leaders, especially before the pre-independence. And commitment and perseverance has always seen with the Jaffna people. In my grade classes, we were told that the Jaffna people are hardworking, and with this beautiful small area of land, they fertilized with lot of human effort. Even when it comes to some commodities, they were able to feed the other part of the country. So that, for many reasons as such, I am happy to be here in this wonderful part of Sri Lanka. And as I initially mentioned, Jaffna was an educational hub. Some southern people from southern parts of Sri Lanka also came here to get the education. And Jaffna Hindu College, Hartley College Jaffna, Jaffna Central College, Uduvel Girls College, some of these are the examples for this concept of educational hub in Jaffna. I think the establishment of University of Jaffna, I think it could be considered as installing a jewel in the crown of Jaffna education system. We have to learn from the history. If you take the 1974, the decision was made by a Sinhalese leader-led government, Mrs. Bandara Nayaka. But then the Minister of Education was representing another community, Honorable Badruddin Mohammed. So then the first Vice Chancellor or the President, it was inaugurated as the 6th campus of Sri Lankan University or the University of Sri Lanka. So, Professor Kalyasapati. His whole three communities were got together to establish this great seat of learning. So there we could get a lesson to the modern day our society. And in the original plan, the Faculty of Law was there. But for some reasons, the establishment of a law department delayed by years, and it was realized only 2005. Some of my great friends were involved in this task. At the time, Mr. Selva Kumaran and myself were deans of the faculties of the University of Calcutta. I think he shared the experience with the establishment of the Department of Law here. Then Deepika Udukama, people like that. And a lot of people who involved in this task were some of my friends. I am proud about that. Then the Sri Lankan education system or the higher education system greatly shared with the British system, where more importance was given to humanities and social sciences. But if you take the United States, they gave more importance to what the country wanted at the time. The development. So the technology, engineering, scientific breakthroughs, and they were the priorities in the American education system. And as a result, they were able to supersede as a country some of the European counterparts. In the Asia, in fact, Japan became the first developed country in Asia. But they also followed mostly the American model. But this debate over whether humanities and social science or the technology and other things still there. But economic demands more technology, more engineering, more working people. So that those countries who follow that, now, even if you take Korea, subsequently Malaysia, and all of those countries are going ahead of us. We need some reforms in our education. Still, greater majority of our graduates are coming from humanities and social science faculties. It's more than 50%. Recently, UGC is trying to come up with new stream, that is technology stream. Professor Vadivel knows very well that we are working very hard with almost all the universities to establish technology faculties and technology streams. So the country needs not only high-level engineers, but a lot of middle-level technocrats. Universities could not address this problem for years. So we need some reforms in our education. And also, social science graduates has to be produced on the basis of what the market demands. So therefore, that we have to, not only theoretical subjects, we have to build in these graduates with skills as well. So therefore, at the UGC, we try to work with the universities to bring these necessary reforms. That's for nothing, but for their own future. But still, the law is not exactly defined whether it is a humanity or social science. But law is one of the important subjects. Its necessity cannot be undermined under any circumstances. As Honorable Chief Justice highlighted, with the changes in the technology and the changes in the economic model and all that, with some reforms, law becomes necessary element of the society. Therefore, in one hand, we have to enhance technology-based, science-based education, and also we have to produce graduates not only who could survive within our small island. We have to produce them for the world market, which requires skills. On the other hand, subjects like law, the need of the subject like law is also increasingly felt by the society. Today, the lawyers being produced by the system, whether it is locally, whether it is faculties, are not only going to the law profession, but also demand for lawyers are coming from the corporate world. I know some of my good friends, they are working as very senior executives in private corporates. The one of the popular areas is HRM and human resource management. Not only that, there are quite a big number of lawyers serving in big corporates. So the knowledge of law is not only to the legal institutions, but also almost all other economically important institutions need the knowledge of law. So therefore they are recruiting more and more law graduates for law professionals to their corporates. But this is the current trend that we witness today. On the other hand, in the fields of humanities and social sciences, I would say this is the only professional degree coming from that area. When you take medicine, it's another professional degree, maybe engineering. Almost other degrees are not trained people for a profession. They are training people for open market, open society. But this is from social sciences and humanities, we train lawyers for a profession. But now, these professions are expanding their boundaries. Their services are being felt by almost other areas as well. Therefore, I'm sure there is a bright future for the Department of Law. University of Jaffna. It is nice to hear that students admitting into this faculty, this department, are from all communities. In fact, the new policy of admission, the admitting students to different programs and different universities, will be purely based on merit. But I have to say something before that. There is a national policy of admitting students to different study programs, not for university. Say medicine is a study program. Law is a study program. Management is a study program. Respect of the university it offers, there is a national policy. What is that national policy? 40% of students are being selected based on the island merit. For all the medical faculties, 40%. Places goes to merit. 55% goes on the basis of percentage of district population of that district. And 5% goes to academically disadvantaged district. Then the pool of students are being selected to different program on that basis. Then the second level, placing students among different institutions. That's what I am talking about. In future, that will be purely on merit. Then, what the consequence of it? So that sometimes more and more Jaffna students, if they earmark as the one particular university or two or three in Colombo is better, if they apply, if they are qualified, they would go to that university. Even on the other way around, people from other parts of the country could come to Jaffna purely on merit basis. Placement to universities will be purely on merit in future. So that's, then it's because we are changing the policies, it was not the policy earlier. We are changing the policies to meet the aspiration of these students and the parents. So that Professor Vadivel is also part of this changing process. So he helped us look to understand these things at the University Grant Commission. So, therefore, this, the point here important, the academically, we are rewarding on the basis of merit. For that, otherwise, the communities of this country, students of A-level students of this country getting more and more opportunities to mix up with fellow students from other communities. So that's the dance performance that performed in the morning here today is, it's a kind of Sri Lankan identity. It's not Tamil identity, it's not Sinhalese identity, or otherwise. That we have to get closer and closer to common Sri Lankan identity than narrowly defined Tamil identity, Sinhalese identity, or Muslim identity. Because I'm sure if the justice is prevailing for everybody, if the economy is booming, all these differences will disappear. We have suffered enough as a nation. The people in Jaffna, as well as people in northern, southern part of the country, suffered a lot. One main reason is that our economy was not able to meet the aspiration of the people. If we can develop this economy very fast, most of these problems automatically will be solved. Why I'm saying that? Today, Asia shared about 25% of the GDP of this world. But in 15 to 20 years' time, it will go up to 50% of the world's GDP. So that means, in proportionately, is our GDP is growing, our GDP per capita will go up to $7,000-$8,000 a year. But if our leaders can do a better job, maybe the limit is sky. That can go further. But the necessary condition is a peaceful country. And also investment in right direction. I am sure current government has identified one of the priority areas of investment as education, as well as higher education. I am sure this government as well as future governments will understand this need, so that a country, there is a big correlation between the expenditure for education and the economic development. Today still, we are a middle income country. Recently we reached that level. But educational expenditure from among the middle income countries is not compared to other countries. We have not come to the level required. But the current government commitment seems to be better. But we need more investment into this education. We hope the government will identify this need and do the needful in the future as well. So that Jaffna University as well get its share. I am sure under Professor the Vice Chancellor, able Vice Chancellor's leadership, right now you are getting more than your deserved share. There are faculties coming up Kilinochi, lot of investments. As the engineers tell us, they need equipment according to the Washington Accord or something. So a lot of investment is needed to maintain the quality of the engineering faculty. I hope we are going to do that. So that other faculties also, students, hostels, the Vice Chancellor says, you all are sending us students from all over, we need more hostels. I think more hostels are coming up. And even the Vice Deans are very busy. They're working very closely with the UGC. I think there is no big funding problem for the university sector. With these remarks, I would like to conclude my small speech. Once again, thank you very much for inviting this beautiful part of this our country. I love your food. I love to visit places of importance. So, at least after being appointed to this position, I had visited, I think about earlier also. This is, I think, third visit. So, always we are there to help you. So, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for that informative address. We wish the University Grants Commission every success in propelling the standards of education in Sri Lanka to higher levels. Now, the Needham Law Journal, which is annually published by the Law Student Society, was scheduled to be released in the previous academic year, which, due to unavoidable circumstances, was unfortunately not possible. Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivapadasundaram and Mr. Madhavathenakun, invited as special guests today, were previously invited as the chief guest and guest of honor, respectively, for the Needham event, which did not take place. However, this would be the opportune time and platform to launch the fifth volume of the Needham Law Journal. On that note, I would kindly request Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivapadasundaram to make her address on the Needham Law Journal. We would also like to thank you, ma'am, for your message to the Suvaniyam.
Thank you. His Lordship, the Chief Justice, Mrs. Ripavan, Vice Chairman of University of Grants Commission, Professor Gunarat, Vice Chancellor of University of Jaffna and Senior Professor, Vasanthi Arasaratnam, Honorable High Court Judge, Mr. Ilan Shalyan, Senior State Counsel, Madhavadenakon, Professor Dr. Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law, Honorable Judges, Honorable Members of Bar, President, Secretary, Executive Committee Members of the Law Students Association, Students of Law Faculty and Distinguished Invitees, Honored Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen. It gives me a great pleasure to participate at this historical event of Aluminum Jubilee Celebration of the Department of Law, University of Jaffna and launching Needham Magazine, which marks the fifth edition of the Law Students Association. In fact, the Department of Law at the University of Jaffna was inaugurated in 2005. Today, there are about 271 law students getting their education. Standing on the threshold of bring forth the fifth edition of the Needham Magazine, I am inspired and energized by the success, esteem and acclaim that was enjoyed by the first issue of Needham in 2009. In the wake of the success, the Law Student Association presents this issue in the fervent hope and expectation that it would attract the foreign and local academics, professionals and students due to the quality and diversity of the articles with eminent researchers found in the magazine. What a surprise! The valuable articles in the field of law written by the distinguished academics, members of judiciary, diplomats, lawyers, and assiduous students speak about the great, classic, and extensive penetrating research to make this publication a success and reality. I congratulate all valuable contributors, editors, and the organizing committee who have taken immense efforts to launch this NIDA magazine. As far as I am concerned, that this publication is a welcome development which enriches their research capabilities and knowledge. Still, the articles indubitably play a significant role. The first article appears in the magazine is written by a British Member of Parliament, Mr. Clare Shaw, is in connection with the challenges facing the international humanitarian system, and it identifies many positive policy responses and humanitarian emergencies. Further, this article speaks about the terrible humanitarian crisis developed in Somalia in 1992, genocidal slaughter of a million of Rwanda, terrible border war between Ethiopia and Eritrea in 1998, and the progress of UN peacekeeping operations. Anyhow, even there were failures in 2002, the meeting convened at Johannesburg reveals that there was a sustainable development. At the conclusion, the author states that we have the capacity to bring humanitarian relief impartially and effectively to all who are in need. Furthermore, he went on to say that we have the capacity to improve the effectiveness of UN peacekeeping operations by allowing the commitment of the UDHR. On the whole, this article speaks about the inaugurating human rights across all the sectors has been recognized as a major development in the 21st century. Mr. Clare is trying to stress the point that the entire UN system has developed explicit policies to incorporate human rights into the field of intervention. This magazine incorporates another article with the heading of Combating Torture in Sri Lanka through International Human Rights Law, which is presented by Honorable High Court Judge Mr. Ilanchalian. Torture is not only the violation of fundamental rights, but also the criminal offense under the Torture Act No. 22 of 1994. The fourth article is about prevention of child labor in Sri Lanka, written by the Honorable District Judge Ganesh Raja. In Sri Lanka, a child is defined in a legal system as well as the Children's Charter in 1992, a Sri Lankan policy document that seeks to harmonize Sri Lanka's commitments under the Convention on the Rights of the Child. The Children's Charter defines a child as a person from birth up to 18 years. International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights Act, which was enacted in 2007, defines a child as from birth of 18 years. This author has done vast research touching all the enactments and come to the conclusion that these acts provide a comprehensive regime which seeks to protect children from exploiter labor. Therefore, the author is of the opinion that every child is a unique and valuable human being, and every child has the rights to be treated fairly and equally. Mr. Tachanamurthy, retired judge, has written an article about the payment of gratuity. Section 31B of the Industrial Dispute Act provides provisions for the payment of gratuity. Because the liability for the payment of gratuity arises on termination of the services. No doubt, the author of this article has eliminated with the case laws about the circumstances on which the gratuity is payable to a workman. The sixth article appears with the heading of The Law is Violent Thing. The author is retaining one incident as remembrance from which acquired the knowledge to the effect that it had been a violent thing and how the democratic further future would be. On this whole, it is a political approach. The seventh article is Emerging Doctrine of the Responsibility to the Protect and the Nature of the United Nations. This had been a speech at Lalit Atharat Mundali's Memorial Oration 2013. Author is His Excellency Nirupam Sen. There are so many articles which are, I think, those are the very valuable articles and the others have taken much effort to bring out these articles at success. On the whole, I would like to emphasize the fact that this Nisa magazine is a well-researched publication which will help to the students, law students, the professors, the learners, academics, and every person who is concerned with the law. Thank you very much for the time which has been given to me to speak about Nida magazine, which is a very, very nice and very intellectual publication, which will help each and everybody in the law field. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am, for that summation and review of the prominent articles contained in the Law Journal. Now I would like to call upon Mr. Madhavasenakun to address the gathering on the Needham Law Journal. We would also like to take this time to thank you, Mr. Senakun, for the guest lectures conducted on international criminal law and on the provincial high courts. Similarly, we would like to thank you, sir, for offering your services as a guest lecturer to the Department of Law.
Your Lordship, the Chief Justice, Professor Kularatna, Vice Chairman of UGC, Professor Arsratnam, Vice Chancellor, Professor Jnanakumaran, the Dean of Faculty of Arts, Professor Ramesh, Honorable High Court Judge Mr. Lanchenian, Honorable High Court Commissioner Mrs. Sivapath Sundaram, Honorable Members of the Judiciary, Members of the Bar, University staff, distinguished guests, and students. It is indeed a great pleasure and honor for me to be invited to join you this morning on this important occasion, which celebrates the existence of the Law Department of this university for 10 years, and also the launch of the magazine Needham. And I could hear it being said many a times that this launch of the magazine was scheduled for somewhere last year. We even received some invitations, but due to some unforeseen reasons, it had to be postponed. In fact, I was looking forward to attend to that event even last year. So when I was invited by Dr. Ramesh, she said, "You are expected to speak a few words." Then I asked her, "What do you mean by a few words?" She said, 2 to 3 minutes. I think I have already spent about 2 minutes. Then I said, "I always come here, I speak to the students in this university, and I remember a few years ago I conducting my first guest lecture here on international criminal law in this very auditorium." So I said, is there a real necessity for me to talk? Because whenever I come to this university, I keep on talking at times 2 to 3 lectures per day, because I have to get back more or less the same evening. Then she said, "No, since you are coming as a guest, you make a speech." Then I said, "I think I am the only person who has come to this university on each and every occasion as a guest, because I always come as a guest lecturer." Anyhow, on a more serious note, His Lordship the Chief Justice mentioned about the necessity to be disciplined, not only as lawyers or as academics in the legal field, but also in every sphere of life. As a member of the bar, as a lawyer who is practicing nearly for 2 decades, I have seen what it really means, because when I joined the Attorney General's Department about nearly 19 years ago, His Lordship, the Chief Justice, was a Deputy Solicitor General who was well respected for his simple but firm mannerism. And it was people like His Lordship the Chief Justice who basically set examples to us at that time as junior officers of the Attorney's Department as to what discipline and commitment really means. Therefore, I also would like to reiterate those words mentioned by His Lordship the Chief Justice, because as you all know, the majority, I would say the 99% of the students who would pass out with a law degree would end up being lawyers practicing in Sri Lanka or becoming the members of the honorable judiciary or in the official bar or in the private bar or become university academics. So this is one of the most important lessons I think we will have to learn or we will have to inculcate in not only with regard to law students but with regard to students of each and every sphere of education. As it was mentioned, for the last few years I have been coming and going to this university as a guest lecturer, and at times, despite some busy work schedules with your coursework and various other commitments, but every single visit I made to this place I have enjoyed, for the simple reason of the commitment shown not only by the academic staff but also by the students. It's very interesting and inspiring to see such a combination of students, basically, geographically, ethnically, and also gender-wise, very well balanced set of students. So I always enjoy the visits I have made to this university as a guest lecturer during the past few years. Without wasting much time, I would like to congratulate the Department of Law on its completion of 10 successful years and also at the launch of the magazine Needle. We all know that it's still 10 years is a very small period when you compare it with the other law schools which had been in existence in this country, and especially when you compare it with some of the law schools which have been in existence for more than 5-6 centuries in other parts of the world. But I'm sure with the commitment shown by the academic staff as well as the non-academic staff and also the other government organs which are responsible for running the university, I think this law department will eventually become one of those great institutes of or great schools of law in time to come. So let me wish you all the very best and wish you a very happy year ahead. And thank you very much for inviting me for this wonderful occasion.
Thank you, sir, for those heartfelt and promising words to the students and to the Department of Law. Now, to officially launch the Needham publication, we would like to invite the Vice Chancellor to present the first copy to the chief guest. Now we like to call upon the Vice Chancellor once again to remain and present the copy to the Vice Chairman of the UGC, Professor P.M.S. Gunaratna. If I could humbly ask Mr. Gunaratna to present a copy of the journal to the Vice Chancellor. If I may call upon the Vice Chancellor once again to present the next copy of the journal to Honorable Mr. M. Ilanchalia. I would like to call upon Honorable Mrs. Kanaga Sivakadasundaran to receive a copy of the journal from the hand of the Vice Chancellor. I would also like to request Mr. Madhava Tenakun to receive a copy of the journal. I would request the Vice Chancellor to present the Law Journal to Senior Professor Mr. N. Nanakumaran. Now we invite Professor Subhatini Ramesh, Head of the Department of Law, to accept the journal. Thank you, Madam, for presenting the initial copies of the journal. For purposes of general awareness, I would like to make known that the Needham Law Journal will be priced at ₹1,000, but purchases of the journal made today will be sold at a discounted price of ₹700. We would now like to invite Mr. S. Paramaraja, retired High Court Commissioner of Jaffna, to present his review on the Needham Law Journal. We also take this time to thank you, sir, for the visiting lectures conducted on criminal law.
Vice Chancellor of the University of Jaffna and other honorable members in the podium, lecturers, professors, and students. This is indeed a great opportunity for me to review the Needham magazine launched by the law faculty. In fact, at the very beginning, I must confess that the delay in launching this magazine gave me a little opportunity to go through the articles that were published in this magazine. Also, I must confess that I could not go through the very first article or the speech by the British or the Member of Parliament due to pressure of time and demands on my time. But I must thank Honorable High Court Commissioner Kanar Govasundra for going and reviewing that article on my behalf. So I am free from that duty. Now let me go to the other articles in this magazine. There is a very interesting article by the Honorable High Court Judge Melanchthon on human international combating torture through international legal aspects. We all know that torture has become a big problem today, not only in Sri Lanka, all over the world, because of the terrorism that is on the rise in almost all parts of the countries. In this article, Honorable Justice Ranjalian has dealt with how the torture is being dealt international by international legal aspects, and also how in this country this system is being developed to combat torture in a very good manner. And also it has been pointed out in this article that when a court that has the jurisdiction to issue writs come across a violation of human rights, under Article 126 of the Constitution, it should be promptly reported to the Supreme Court. This is a very good aspect in our Constitution, which I think other countries do not have. Then, regarding the other articles in this magazine, I find an article written by the High Court Judge of Tringamalli regarding passing off. Passing off is a matter that has to be considered very seriously in developing countries where the consumers may be cheated by producing, by marketing their products under a trade name or under the getup of other items that are already in the market with a good goodwill. So the violation of this is a serious offense, and it is in fact very good article regarding the passing off. There's also an article in this magazine by Honorable Ganesha Raja, District Judge of Batikolo, regarding child labor. And he has analyzed this to a great extent, how the children and young women are protected in this country, and the child labor, how the children are protected from child labor in this country. Yet he has also, he has pointed out in his article to what extent the child labor is being done in this country by giving the statistics. Then again I find another article by written by Tachiramati, retired High Court Judge, retired District Judge, regarding on the subject of gratuity in our country. He has analyzed Section 31 of the this article, and also the jurisdiction of the Labour Tribunal and Industrial Dispute Act and Section 31B of the Industrial Dispute Act. Then there is another article about Parate Executive that is written by a student of this university. Parate Executive, we know it's a right given to the money lending institutions to take back the loan given by them without having recourse to the court of law. The mortgagee can sell the property without having going to the court and getting it sold by a public auction. This right is given to money lending organization. First it was given to the state banks, and now it has been given to all banks if the amount is over 5 million. And this matter has been very clear analyzed in this article. Again, another article regarding the legislative powers conferred on the provincial councils under the 13th Amendment. This article has been written by Pravinath, lecturer of the Jaffna University. In this article, the legislative power of the parliament and that of the provincial councils have been discussed. The 7th article has been written by Ms. J.N.T. D. Silva, attorney at law, on the issue of homosexuality. And it has been pointed out this minority group's rights should be protected, and they should be given the medical rights also. The 8th article was written by Tulsi Dharmaprasingam about judicial review of administrative law, a student of this faculty. This article explains further the method by which the judiciary checks the administrative acts whenever it is ultra vires or in violation of the natural justice or when it is against the legitimate expectation. I found another very good article in this magazine about international law and domestic law by a third year student and inhuman cruel degrading activities in Sri Lanka by Rosalila Aryavansa, and another article in international law in the context of Sri Lanka by another third year student, and also another article on prevention of sexual harassment in working institutions in Sri Lanka by Surya Balendra, a first year student, and another article on general aspects of competition of law and practices under Sri Lankan legal system. This is an attempt to protect and promote the consumer welfare, economic welfare, and this matter has been very well explained in this article. This article also deals with unfair competition rules and principles which are contrary to public. There is another article regarding protection of women during armed conflict under international humanitarian law by a fourth year student. And also I find an article on Muslim law by regarding the quasi court procedure. And also there is another article for the need of a minimum mandatory sentence. In this article, the conflict with section 3642E with article 4C, 11 and 12.1 of the Constitution has been discussed. This is a, in fact, this is a matter that arose in Attorney General versus Ranasinghe, and this matter has been dealt with in this article. Another article is there about the cyber defamation that has been in this, about the cyber defamation. And in this article, how it has been dealt with in countries like America and Canada has been discussed. And there is another article by a fourth year student regarding protection of women under the police administration in Sri Lanka. A very good suggestion has been given in this article that there must be at every police station a woman officer to receive the complaints made by the women. Then I found another article here that is about Queen versus the famous case Queen versus Liana Gay. That is a case where an attempt was made to seize the state power by top-ranking officers of the armed forces and the police. In that case, the judiciary asserted itself and refused to hear twice the case by the court constituted by the executive at the time. In fact, in that matter, as it has been pointed out in that article, it was the then Minister of Justice, Felix S. Bandaranaike, who single-handedly fought to establish once again the democracy in this country and bring to book those who attempted to seize the power. In that case, though it was an attempt, the case started with an attempt to seize the power and close down the democratic institutions in this country, finally when the case went up before the Privy Council, the law lords there went back as far as 1833 to the year when Lord Cameron along with Lord Colebrook visited, I think it was in 1833, visited Sri Lanka to send their reports on the reformations of judiciary and the legislative system that prevailed in this country at the time. Their law lords in the Privy Council decision went back to this report made by Cameron and stressed that there was an independence of judiciary in this country in that judgment. It is that judgment that gave the insight that about the independence of the judiciary in this country, and we find that a case that started to take away the rights of the people, to take away the independence of the judiciary, finally ended up in establishing the rights of the judiciary through the judgment of the Privy Council. On the whole, I would say this is a very good publication by the law students. Within 10 years, they were able to publish this magazine, which is the fifth magazine, that is at the rate of one magazine per 2 years. They have been publishing this. This is a very good effort. But I am rather disappointed to see that though this magazine has been published on Jaffna, there was no article about Desamala Vanavaya in this magazine. There is no, and also the criminal side of the law has been totally abandoned in this magazine. There is no article about the criminal law. There was no article about Desamala in this. I think it should be in the, should be taken into consideration when you publish the other issues in the next year or following years, because the fragrance of the soil must be there in the middle. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir, for that conscientious and scrupulous review of the Law Journal. Thank you for the constructive feedback given. We will be mindful to keep in mind the advice given regarding the Thesavalame law and criminal law, essential articles towards it to the, on the journal. We would now like to invite Honorable Mr. M. Elanchalian to address the gathering on the Aluminum Jubilee celebration.
My Lord, Honorable Chief Justice, Sri Bhavan sir, Honorable Deputy Chairman, University Grants Commission, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Vasanthi Asaratnam, Honorable High Court Judge, Mrs. Sobhar Sundaram, Honorable Dean Arts Faculty, Jana Kumaran, Professor Head of Law, Ramesh, our brother judges, Jaffna Peninsula, Mana and Trigravali, learned state councils, honorable retired judges, commissioners, learned counsels, attorneys, law undergraduates, and the other students of Jaffna University, members of staff, professors, retired vice chancellors, Professor Mogradas, Professor Kumaravadivel, former Dean of Arts, Professor Sivachandra, distinguished gathering, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I like to welcome our Honorable Lordship, Honorable Chief Justice Sri Bhavan, to visit to Jaffna University as a chief guest to celebrate this Aluminum Jubilee of the Law Department. As a High Court Judge of Jaffna, I welcome you, sir, on behalf of our Jaffna Judiciary and the Judiciary of the Northern Province. I don't like to deliver any speech. My head and our Chief Justice is in the stage. We have maintained the protocol. He has delivered the landmark speech. I think so. This is the first public speech after the appointment of the Office of the Chief Justice, delivered by the Honorable Chief Justice Sri Bhavan. According to his experience, I have not seen he never delivered unnecessarily public speeches. His quality He maintained the quality not only from the Ethics Department, but also from the judiciary. Our Honorable Chief Justice maintained that discipline. Today, he delivered a landmark speech regarding the discipline, law, justice. My humble request to this forum, we are facing the difficulties of social justice. Our undergraduates, not only law graduates, no law undergraduates, but also other graduates, please comply with the order of your head of the institution, Vice Chancellor Professor Vasanthi Arasaratnam, to maintain law and order, not only within the university premises, but also outside the university premises. Recent past, we have some experiences. We all are law graduates. Here, our Jaffna judiciary, all are law graduates from Columbus University, all are internal students, especially. We are ready to assist the law department as a visiting lecturer if our Chief Justice allows us to deliver the lectures. That matter should be looked after by the Professor Arasaratnam and our Chief Justice to settle this matter. We are graduates, we are Columbia University graduates, we have a master's degree, we have a master's degree. Most of the 99% of the Jaffna judiciary are law graduates. If the university invites us, we are ready to deliver the lectures to our law undergraduates. I have to give a commendation to the law department. The products of the law graduates are playing the leading role in our court complexes in Jaffna and the other complexes of the northern provinces. Now all these Jaffna University law graduates are in Magistrate Court, High Court, Civil Appellate High Court. The highest standard of English speaking, argument. So we are very happy to see the youngsters in Jaffna Bar. They are playing the big role in our fair trial judicial service, judicial administration of justice system. Our Lordship, Honorable Chief Justice, delivered the good speech regarding the discipline of students, lawyers, judges, and the other lawmakers. Lawyers are leaders. Tomorrow, lawyers are judges. Tomorrow, lawyers are lawmakers. I request our Deputy Chairman, University Grants Commission, during my time, when I was a student of university, he joined in 1981, he joined the management department. I think so, he's a very strict officer for the marshal in charge during our ragging time. I have seen his face, now small changes. But just now only our chairman explained to me his wife is a lawyer. Daughter is a lawyer. So I request our Honorable Chairman, please. Now, the 10 years is more than enough. 1 decade, law department. During my time, we were in the law department under the Professor Nadaraja. I think so 1982-83 is declared as a law faculty. First dean is the Professor Nadaraja. The second is the Professor G.L. Peeris. One and only law professor. Completed his vice chancellor post in Columbia University, that is only Professor G.L. Peeris. No other professors from law as a vice chancellor. During his period only, Columbia University, the Faculty of Law is well organized, developed, and established all systems. Now we all are, from the students of the Professor G.L., when he was the first dean of the second dean of the law faculty. Therefore, my humble request to the chairman, deputy chairman, whatever the infrastructure, whatever the shortages of the staff, whatever the shortages of the lecturers, that's not an excuse for another 10 more years. Please, within 1 or 2 years' time, promote the law department as a faculty of law of the University of Colombo. If there is any difficulty, we are law graduates. I am a postgraduate. There are a lot of postgraduates are here. We are ready to help to establish and promote the system. It should be. Why? The chairman explained the system. Only two faculties are the professions. One is medical faculty, another one is law faculty. Not the other faculty. Other faculties are academic. We are lawyers. They are doctors. Doctors are wearing the white gown, the lawyers are wearing the black gown. Therefore, this is our humble request to the UGC chairman, deputy chairman. Give the assistance to our professor Vasanthi, as a Ratna. He will help you. She's a biochemistry scientist. she will promote whatever your instruction, she will promote. And our dean of faculty of arts, very soft corner gentleman, Professor Jnanakumaran. He is our guru's own brother. We are former dean of faculty of law, Jnanakumaran students, all are students. So, with the Jnanakumaran's professor, senior lecturer, and the former dean, Jnanakumaran's help, Professor Jnanakumaran's blessing, I ask the request the deputy chairman, please consider our request. If there is a difficulties, we all, the Jaffna, you know, the Jaffna is a better place for the lawyers. G.G. Ponnambalam, S.D.M. Selvanayagam, Dr. Sirichendram, these are landmark experts, lawmakers of Sri Lanka. So we can't tolerate another 10 more years for law faculty. So this is enough. 10 years enough. In my view, I am not interested to listen to the infrastructure, shortages, and that is this. If your mind is clear, if the government's mind is clear, tomorrow it can be promoted as a law faculty. Because we are happy to see the president of the All Boys Association, Manivannan. So happy to see the State Council, Vishandar. They are leading figures of Jaffna University products. So tomorrow we can see several judges from Jaffna University products. We are waiting for that, because now nearly 25 to 50 people are Jaffna University products are in our court complex. So therefore, we need your assistance. Another thing is, final word is, my students, you know the Jaffna situation. Social crimes, sword fighters, Jaffna University, students are best students, better quality students. We know from 1974, this complex is Kailasabadi Arang. Who is Kailasabadi? He's one of the expert professors of this university. So please, if there are any troubles, don't take your hands. Don't go for violent, non-violent protest, and other things may be all right. But violent protest not allowed. Within the university is a big problem. Outside the university is another problem. The police officers are coming up and down, running courthouses. The university students are in the cell. Our judges don't like to see the university students are in the cell. You are future leaders. Now ragging is an offense. During our period, ragging is not an offense. So we did it. Now it's an offense. So maintain the law and order. Because that's law is law. So you have to obey the law, comply the law. So ragging is a law. One person is not wearing the belt. There's a big fight. I don't know what's the reason of the fighting. They're not wearing the juniors refused to remove the belt. So please, Your best professors are here, best vice chancellor is here. They are always cooperate with you. They are even a final resort, even a last resort only, they are approaching the police officers in the court. Last resort, not the first resort. They are giving the opportunities. So, even if you are in the courthouse, found guilty, convicted, tomorrow you have no job. Because if you go for any interviews, do you have any convictions? Do you have any found guilty in courthouse? No government job. So we have to settle the cases. Our judges are trying to settle the case because you are a student. You are an undergraduate. Tomorrow you have a great future. Whatever the cases come, our judges ask the lawyers, can't you settle the matter? We can deliver the judgment free and fair, we can deliver the judgment, that's what our way. We think about the future of the student. So, in future, our vice chancellor is here, in front of the vice chancellor, I am telling you, comply the order of the vice chancellor. Comply the order of the dean of faculty of law, dean of the faculties and the heads of the faculties. Maintain the law and order from the student community. Marshals, this is within the university. Outside the university, please, 5,000 rupees the Mahabala scholarship and bursary. If you go to the 5 o'clock in the surrounding bus, maybe 20% of the university students are there. With the government money, 5,000 rupees. Government is paying for money and another protest is going, money is not enough. So your parents are watching. Your parents are not allowed to go to the police stations and the bar and the courthouses. So we have, every day we receive the complaints. Our learned magistrates are running behind the police officers. Not to arrest the university students, not to bring the people. Level your best to settle the matters. Otherwise, if the case comes before the magistrate, there's a difficult problem for remand. So therefore, this is my humble request. We have to reduce the crimes. I thankful to our Lordship the Chief Justice, sir, we are very proud. Under your leadership of this country, we had two Chief Justices, Chief Justice Sharwananda, Honorable Chief Justice H.T. Tambayya, maybe Chief Justice Nagalingam, maybe Chief Justice of the Acting Chief Justice, I not remember. After 25 years, 1990, the Chief Justice, Justice Tambayya, after that, our Justice Sribhavan is in the head of the judiciary. He is ever in the Himalaya. Sir, we promise you, we give the assurance on behalf of the Jaffna judiciary. We control the crimes. We prevent all crimes. We never abuse the powers. We never exceed the powers. During your term, we are doing everything best. We are happy to say, we are now the Jaffna judiciary, madam told me about few comments about me. Not only for my work, but also our entire team. Our Jaffna judge, Leonard Sadisaran, Mallaram judge, we all are in the corners. One is in the Kites, another one is in Vadamaraji Coast, another one is Madagal Coast, another one is Savakari Coast, another one is Budanari Coast. See, we are controlling the Kerala Kanja. Now no Kerala Kanja inside the Jaffna. We totally, all the judges are in the boundary line. So we are controlling the social justice. Delivering the judgment is different. The judgment, we hear the case for 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. Delivering the judgment and giving the decision letters. Last week I delivered the judgment for 1994 India case. 22 years. What's the result of the society? So now immediate our pressure is drugs, child abuse, and other sword fights, gang fights, everything is now is little under control. Last night, there is a chain of robberies in Kopal. See, our judges are 24 hours alert. Police officers are 24 hours, they are running behind the B reports. We definitely, within 1 or 2 weeks time, we will arrest all the people. That as a high court judge, I am telling you all, if there's a crime, whatever the bail, first we have to think about the society. Community should be protected. Society should be protected. Then only we have to think about the other side. So Thank you for your patience hearing. Thank you very much. I thank you to the Lordship Chief Justice. During his command, his leadership, we are happy to work here fearlessly, free and fair. We are delivering the justice. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for reiterating the importance of discipline and for the valuable advice given. The Law Student Society annually conducts debate competitions among schools in the Northern Province and among different faculties of the University of Jaffna. We would like to present the awards for those competitions at this prestigious event. To do the honours, I would like to invite the Chief Guest, Honourable K. Srivavan, to present the awards for the Schools Debate Competition, Northern Province. Congratulations to Hindu College Jaffna, who emerged champions. I would like to kindly request the entire team to come on stage. The captain, Parameshwaran Garcharan, Vigneshwaranadan Sarangan, Sivaraj Vishakanan, and Ravi Chandran Krivusankan. If the team members could kindly remain on stage. Also now like to present as a trophy the cash prize that was promised. So if you could do the honors. The runners up were Muleti Vijayananda College, Captain Vice, Raj Singham Purvika, Tankavela Idam Vinuja, Selvarasa Parthipan, Mahendran Durka. Selvarasa Parthipan will represent the entire team and will take the awards on behalf of his teammates. St. John's College Jaffna tied with Wormbury Girls High School for second runners-up. Participants of St. John's College, captained by Chandrakant and Vilakshan Joel. Thayaparan Raghavan. Dilipan Sukirtan. And Will Nambi Satusigal. Kindly come forward to receive the trophy. Participants of Wormbury Girls High School, captained by Akshana Anandasayanan, Tanisha Sebastian Kood, Shambhavi Bhaskaran, and Virintika Arishala. Thank you, sir, for presenting the awards. We would now like to call upon the Vice Chairman of the University Grants Commission, Professor P.M.S. Gunaratna, to present the awards to the winners of the Inter-Faculty Debate Competition. The champions were the Faculty of Engineering, The participants were Balasubramanian Nilakshan, Ratna Kumar Maidan, Mudita Kumarasiri, KRS Lanka Priya. Balasubramanian Nilakshan was also secured best debater of the tournament, and Ratna Kumar Maidan, as a representative of the team, will receive the awards on behalf of his team. The runners-up were the Faculty of Management Studies and Commerce. The team comprised of Y.F. Shifana, N. Purvalan, M. Jatarika, and T.T.S. Karunaratnam. We would like to thank you, sir, for presenting the awards. Now we invite the Vice-Chancellor, Senior Professor Ms. Vasanthi Arasaratnam, to present the awards for the intra-department competitions. The debate competitions. The ninth batch of law students emerged champions. The team consisted of Muhammad Isharji, Neesanayagam Isdervan, Gopalasingam Khem Prakash, if we could also present the trophy to the team members. No, there is no trophy, I'm really sorry. The eighth batch of law students, if you could kindly remain to present the runners-up awards. The runners-up awards, ma'am. The eighth batch of law students came in second. The team members were Rochelle Aryavansa, Saravana Muthukuga Priya, and Tanushka L. Pitiya. The second runners-up were the 10th batch of law students. The team members were Mohammed Fatima Ajra, Hanesan Tulasi, and Sri Skandaraja Sivakandasi. The best debater of the competition was Mohammed Ishaddin. The speech competitions. In first place, Sinaratha Dhananjay. In second place, Mohammed Fatima Ajra. And in third place, Sahani Udara Vijaypur. The essay competitions, in first place, Rochelle Aryavansa. In second place, Charitani Prabhashini. And in third place, Nalina Sivachandran. Thank you, ma'am, for presenting the awards. We would now like to entertain you with a musical performance. I'm sorry. We will now have the speech by the President of the Law Alumni Association, Mr. V. Manivannan. He was scheduled to speak before, but since he has arrived now, let's have his address.
His Lordship, the Chief Justice, Honorable Legos, the Vice Chairman of the University Grant Commission, Professor Gunharjuna, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Jaffna, Professor Basandiyan, the Honorable Judges of the High Court, Mrs. Kanaga Subhalasundaram, Honorable Elantrian, the Senior State Council, Madhavati Nepal, the Dean, Faculty of Arts, Professor Nanakumaran, the Head of the Department, Dr. Subhajit Ramesh, and the other judges, and the retired judges, and the lawyers, and state councils, and heads, and other professors of the University of Jaffna, and my colleagues, and the students, my dear students of the University of Jaffna. Good morning, all of you. I'm sorry that I was late for some unavoidable situation, and I am very pleased to deliver my speech at this very special occasion. It was not the red carpet we walked into this special occasion. It is neither a rose bed. On the contrary, it has been a long journey on the stones and thorns. You all may think that I am using all the clip phrases to enhance my quality of speech, but it is not true. And I am not even exaggerating. Of course, I being a student from the first batch of the department, have personally witnessed every single moment of the journey. Thus, I think I have all the locus standi, or the legal right to share the memories with you. Now, I am delivering this speech in front of you in a very graceful location, in a very beautiful auditorium. But you may wonder if I tell you that though our journey started from this special, this beautiful auditorium on 2nd of May 2005, we had to continue our lectures in a small lecture room with minimum facilities. And of course, with only two lecturers. To add more difficulties, the Memorandum of Understanding between the Government of Sri Lanka and the LTTE has come to an end in 2006, right after 1 year of the commencement of the department. It has been a nightmare to think what happened afterwards. As the A9 road was blocked, with everyone starving for food, it became mission impossible to continue with the studies. Our dreams had to come to an end with the closure of A9. The department activities have been halted for more than 1 year. There were days we waited hopeless, having lost all faith. Students who studied in the law college or the faculty of law in Kalambu have more opportunities to visit courts. But fortunately or unfortunately, we also had the same opportunity to visit the Supreme Court, not to study, but to file a case to start our study here. Yet it became unavoidable as the department was unable to resume its activities, as the only lecturer who served then also has left the country for his higher studies. We fought and we gained. As a result of the legal action, we came to the limelight, and our department activities were transferred to the capital city, where we had the last 3 years of our studies experience. We in fact have seen this rise also. Now we have more number of permanent and visiting lecturers. We have been publishing our own Neeram magazine for the last five years, since 2009. When we launched the Neelam for the first time in 2009, we had the chance to have the Honorable Justice Sri Bhavan sir as the chief guest. Even today, we got the grace to have him not only as the chief guest, but also as the chief justice of this country. The story does not end here. Four judges have passed from the department and enrolled as the attorneys at law. They are into one of the noblest professions in the world. They are the first fruits and giants of the department. They are the proud answers for all questioning, doubtful eye, humiliating faces we encounter. They are now the members of the respectable bar of Sri Lanka. From a war-torn backward city to capital city, we simply made it. I am more than proud to be here to enjoy the golden opportunity of addressing my respectable audience. But in this moment, I wish to air one thing out that we the graduates and the undergraduates have an unaccomplished wish in our hearts. It is upgrading of the Department of Law into the Faculty of Law. I hope that it will happen in the nearer future. And we all will work together in this journey, I promise. I hope we will join again in the celebration of the next Jubilee as members of alumni of the Faculty of Law. The Faculty of Law should involve in serious researchers which should result in social change. Finally, the studies in the Department of Law, University of Jaffna, gave me a lot of experience, happiness and the sadness also. As the Honorable Judge of the High Court, Mr. Elantharian told, I also request the students to obey the orders of the administration, authorities. I heard that a lot of bad things are going on. And also, I request the authorities to deliver orders, to issue orders in terms of natural justice. I thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Manivannan. We also would like to thank the Law Alumni Association for their unconditional support that they have rendered towards the department over the years. On the agenda, Ms. Shanta Abhimanasingham is required to present her address. However, due to health restraints, she is unable to attend the function. But we truly appreciate all that Ms. Abhimanasingham has done for the department, and she will always be remembered and fondly cherished. And she is missed at this occasion. Now, this event would not be complete without thanking those who work persistently to see it through, namely the lecturers of the Department of Law and the Law Student Society. Law Student Society. But before we proceed on to the vote of thanks, we would like to entertain you with a brief musical performance performed by Ms. Nalina Sivachandran and Mr. S. Sivaskandasri.
Thank you.
thank you, Sri Skandaraja and Naina, for that tranquilizing musical display. Now, to draw the curtains on the event, I would like to call upon the Secretary of the Law Student Society, Mr. S. Dineshan, to present the vote of thanks.
Thank you. Good afternoon. It has been 10 years since our Department of Law was inaugurated in the midst of many obstacles and hardship. Nonetheless, the department carries out the business with its quality and with dedication to produce an effective and educated society in Jaffna. We are very too proud to be a part of making this historic occasion, and as a part, we are humbled by all of your presence. I, as a secretary of the Law Student Society, privileged to have this opportunity to thank you all for your presence and also for your support throughout in making this occasion success. First of all, I would like to thank you, His Lordship, Chief Justice of Sri Lanka, for your presence in marking this occasion. His Lordship, your address today carry out message which will echo for years to all students who would come into this display. Your Lordship, we also extend our sincere thanks to you for the message to our souvenir published today, which is recognition of the contribution made by the Department of Law in producing high-qualified lawyers, legal academics, researchers, and officials in various reputed organizations in and out of Sri Lanka. Thank you to Vice Chairman of the University Grant Commission, who had come all the way in this busy schedule. We thank you for not only representing UGC at this historical event, but also for your kind words today. We are very much thankful to the University Crown Commission itself for providing unconditional assistance and guidance throughout in growth of our department. Thank you to our Vice Chancellor, without whom we cannot even imagine the progress and growth the Department of Law has achieved so far in marking this history. Madam, you always treat us like a mother treats her children. And we are very thankful for your unconditional support and for the guidance throughout in making this occasion success. Thank you to our High Court judge for your excellent comments in this occasion. You have not only mentioned how we have to be good leaders and citizens who abide by ethics, but leaving us evidence of inspiration. We are grateful for caring today at our function, but also thank you for your service to our society. Thank you to High Court Commissioner who accepted invitation to come today. We also thank sincere Senior State Counsel Malava Tennakot for taking part in this function all the way from Colombo as special guest. Thanks to our team. Sir, your speech today is a vibrant message to all of our students. With having so much experience, the way you guide us is a treat for us and lesson to be carried out to the next generation of students. Thank you to our head of department, the pillar of this success, Professor Subhadini Ramesh. Madam, you never give up, even at hardship moment. You stay calm and resolve any obstacles that come to the student and department. This function is the witness of your leadership, but more about your hard work spent hours and hours, day and night, to mark this history success. I also take this moment to thank all of our former Vice Chancellors. Professor P. Balasundaram Pillai, Professor S. Moganadas, Professor R. Kumaravadivel, and Professor N. Sanmugalinga, and our former Deans of Faculty of Arts and Head of Department of Law, particularly to Professor V. P. Sivanagar, Professor M. Sinnathambi, Dr. T. Kalamani, and Professor A. V. Manivasagar, for your service today in the progress of our department and for the participation this evening. Thank you to our present and past lecturers and to our coordinator Mr. B. N. Tambu, who had not just taught us the law but taught how to be a successful legal professional with ethics upon completion of our graduation. We particularly thank who are here with us today. You literally toiled yourself in making this event so success, and we are ever grateful. Thank you all judges, presidential councils, attorney at laws, well wishers who had agreed and participated at today's function. We also take this moment to thank everyone personally who had given message to our souvenir and academic article to Needham. We extend our thanks to all staff from the university, academic and non-academic, in marking this history-making function success, which particularly faced with the head of department, coordinator and registrars. Without your coordination, I am sure this 10-year marking would never have been possible. Thank to Harry Anand and Anta Printers, who had print souvenir and need them in time. Thank to all my friends, juniors and seniors who worked hard to make this function success. We also extend our thanks to alumni for being a part in making this event success. Finally, we are very grateful to each and everyone, but also to the God who made this history-making moment success. May justice prevail. Thank you.